The Illinois primary isn't until March 2020, the general election not until November 2020. But still, Republicans came here to the Illinois State Fair to test their campaign message and rally the troops. In a state that has become increasingly Democratic, Illinois Republicans huddled today in Springfield to rebuild. Chairman Tim Schneider admits the GOP was decimated at the ballot box last year.
And we had a rough year. We lost the governor's mansion. We have no statewide office holders, and we lost several legislative seats. But that's our current reality, but it doesn't, and it won't be our future. We can sulk and complain and do nothing, or we can make it better.
As the Republican insiders plot a course forward, they remain upbeat and on the attack.
The socialist agenda. That's not Illinois.
You may have heard of AOC. AOC stands for absolutely out of control. That's what it stands for.
House Speaker Nancy Pelosi was Democrats' special guest yesterday. Today, Republicans countered with Minority Whip Steve Scalise.
You absolutely can take your state back, and you will take your state back by fighting the machine.
Republicans are united in opposition to Governor Pritzker's push to move Illinois from a flat income tax system to a graduated one with the wealthy paying more. They formed a new committee, Vote No on Blank Check Amendment.
I mean, we're up against the richest elected politician in the country. So if we spend $1, he'll spend $2. If we spend $10, he'll spend $20. So I don't think we'll ever outspend him, but it'll be a significant amount of resources put toward this.
Another issue that has united GOP officials, a possible pardon or commutation for Rod Blagojevich. The GOP congressional delegation says no way. In fact, last week, Congressman Darren LaHood spent 15 to 20 minutes on the phone with President Trump, urging him not to do it.
To me, the conduct that Blagojevich engaged in is exactly what we're trying to stop here in Illinois. It's a definition of the swamp, and I explained that. I think the president is a good listener. I think he likes to listen to all sides. I'm one person that weighed in on this. There'll be many others that do that and have done that.
It's also worth mentioning President Trump came up often today. He is very popular downstate, but in Chicago and the suburbs, not so much. And that remains complicated for Illinois Republicans.